Get don't feel like climbing the stairs, I'll be more than happy to throw them out the window. They've been insulted so many times, they'd be insulted if I didn't insult them.
I've been warning you. If you do that one more time, I'll fire you in spite of your bad old man.
Practice is the
sound like such a threat. Being thrown out of this place is slightly better than being thrown out of a leper colony.
Ow!
Mademoiselle Brandt.
It's you again.
Come on.
Where are we going?
Up.
What's up?
My flat.
Oh, thank you. You've been very kind, but no.
Relax. I'm gay.
Oh, God. That's the nicest thing anyone said to me all day. Leon Macduff.
With pleasure, but isn't the correct quote Leon Macduff?
Leon, Leon. What's the difference?
I guess it all depends on if you'd rather be led or lady. It isn't much, but it's cozy. And with a little luck, I might be able to rustle up a nice, strong tea.
Oh, God, the quickest route to a British soprano's cold hearts. Bless you.
It's just a cold. Here. Get out of those wet clothes.
Can I ask you a personal question?
How long have I been gay?
No, how long have you been a hypochondriac?
What makes you think I'm a hypochondriac?
Educated guess. My ex-husband was. The day we married, his ulcer perforated. The day we separated, he broke into shingles. And the day we divorced, he sneezed and lost all the hair on his body.
Oh, heavens. Which I don't, but if I did, I would rather be you.
Me?
Female like you would be just fine.
Well, I guess I can relate to that. There have been times in my life when I honestly wished I were a man.
Oh God, heavens, why?
That's easy. If I were a man, I could do a lot of things a woman never can.
Like what, for example?
Be free to plot and plan. Free to live my life without permission from a man. Man assumes that the world is tailor-made for him, which it is. He presumes that the world indulges every whim if it's his. What a fabulous pursuit. Hands in pockets, running things. I must say, it appeals. In my $100 suit, toying with my golden fob watch as I make my deals. Lucky man who is not made to feel like an
Greatest female tried to act like a woman, which very few can. But the fact is, a drag queen's a man.
What were you saying?
You're not a man.
I'm glad you noticed.
You're a woman, they'll think he's a man. What a plan. Trust me.
Todd, this is absolutely crazy.
Now, being a girl that they think is a man sets their minds in a whirl.
I do!
Trust me. Trust me. All you have to do for the dream to come true is go out there and be what you are. That will make you a world famous star.
Or delirious.
Lower your voice.
Todd.
Lower.
Todd.
I'm more Caruso, less shall you be.
Todd, if you don't get back in my brain.
Very good. Your voice naturally. Don't have to do anything new. Simply do what you do when you're you.
Well, I don't do that!
And the audience won't have a clue. It's true. So, for your plan, to succeed in it can, they must think you're a man. Trust me. If you're a man,
which I'm not,
you'll be the greatest star since show business began. Trust me. Trust me, the beauty of this is like all great ideas. It's as simple can be.
Not my dad.
And we'll have each other to thank.
For what?
For our pet house at the joint set. It's a free ride to the bed.
Okay.
But if you trust me,
should
trust
I?
Me,
what?
Trust me, Victoria, this can work.
Tony, it will not.
An audience believes what they want. And tomorrow afternoon, Andre Cassell will meet Europe's greatest female impersonator.
Andre Cassell is the biggest agent producer in Paris. If I'm the greatest, why hasn't he heard of me?
You are the greatest. You're just unknown outside of Poland. You are Count Victor Brzezinski, a Polish aristocrat. Your family disowned you when they discovered you're gay. We met in Warsaw, fell in love, and I brought you to Paris.
No audience is that gullible. They'll know he's a phony.
It's Andre.
Just a moment.
I'm Carol Todd.
Oh, lucky you.
I'm an old friend of Monsieur Bissell.
Oh, could you please define old friend?
Your employer came to my Christmas party.
Ah, that makes you an old friend.
He stayed until New Year.
Oh.
Andre, Carol Todd, Christmas 32. Hot toddy.
Oh, my God. Toddy! Forgive me, I did not recognize you out of uniform that he placed Santa Claus.
Oh.
And you took a chair upside down on your head and proclaimed yourself one of my reindeer. Prancer, wasn't it?
I honestly don't remember. Now, what can I do for you, old friend?
Actually, it's what I can do for you, old friend. Allow me to introduce Count Victor Grzinski, Europe's greatest female impersonator. Count, if you please.
Oh my goodness!
Did you break anything?
Yes.
What?
Everything.
Oh. Well, what say, old friend? We adjourn to my office and discuss the Count's future in show business, hmm?
By all means. Count?
By all means! After you.
Oh, no, Count. After you.
From now on, you must call me Victor.
Until we meet again, Victor.
Until then.
Thank you.
My new stock.
No, he thinks he's a phony.
What? I think you're very talented.
Well, yeah, he just doesn't think you're you're a man.
I'll tell her what I think.
See?
Normal.
Yeah?
Mingle.
Sure. Okay, to mingle, Mr. Tour.
Victor's performance of standing mingling with you will be the highlight of the evening.
Oh, I just love Frenchmen.
So do I.
You were saying, Mr. Marshall?
But I find it hard to believe that you're a man.
Because you find me attractive as a woman.
Yes, as a matter of fact.
It happens frequently.
Not to me.
Well, it just proves the old adage that there's always a first time.
I don't think so.
Excuse me.
Monsieur Victor. I am honored in the
proprietary
shade of weed. You've heard it before.
Yes.
You have? But you must be there.
Yes.
You have?
No! Yes, I have never been there.
In any event, in any case, when you have, I'm not always in my great
honor. The beans! However, did you get in without an invitation?
Oh, but Todd. An invitation.
Oh, no, what you have is a mistake.
Honey, I won't forget this.
Counting on it!
Oh, God, that was close. Don't ever leave me alone like that again!
Right? If you please excuse us, we have to be going.
What, you did?
I'm nearly golfing.
That's a twin!
Do you play golf?
Golf? Oh, yes, occasionally.
Okay, what's your handicap?
Being gay, what's yours?
Tommy, how did you discover Monsieur Victor?
He walked into my theater and hit a G flat.
Wow, a G flat?
I've never heard of a man being able to sing that high.
You're a gambling man, Mr. Marchand. Care to place a small wager?
How small?
Say 1,000 francs.
Let's make it interesting. Say 10,000.
Forget it.
I thought so.
Make it 20,000.
Bet. Miss Cassidy, it will not be the same without you.
Norma!
Until we meet again. No.
Oh, real soon, I hope.
Norma!
Keep your pants on! Bonsoir.
Bonsoir, no. Which also means he's dangerous.
Dangerous?
Trust me, his manhood is at stake. Which means he will go to great lengths to ensure you are a fraud. Now hurry up and get ready while I make sure the dreaded Labisse isn't lurking at the stage door.
Thank you.
because you know you'd lose.
I'm glad you changed your mind.
Yes, it's quite late. What happened to your bowl cake?
Oh, you canceled it. What? What you did?
I'm flattered.
It's supposed to rain.
Oh, baloney. You'd rather be here. We meet again, Mr. Todd.
It would appear so, Miss Cassidy. Would you care for...
I'd love to.
Let's drink.
Looks like Norm was in for a big surprise, huh?
Why is that?
Well, isn't Mr. Todd? Well, isn't he?
Isn't he what?
You're not gonna help me out with this one, right?
Right.
Isn't he a homosexual?
Well, isn't that something you should ask Mr. Todd?
Are you two lovers?
If you mean, do we love each other? Yes. Do we cohabit? Yes. Do we have sex?
Forget
it. You don't want to know.
No.
Because the idea of two men.
No. Because I'm still not convinced that you're a man.
Your problem, Mr. Marchand, is that you're preoccupied with stereotypes. See, I think it's as simple as you're one kind of a man, I'm another.
And what kind are you?
One that doesn't have to prove it to himself or anybody else.
No.
Yes! 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 Yes!
Kathy heard something unusual.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Like if I got excited.
Jeez!
Just kidding.
I can't get you anything, boss.
When did we move?
During the dress rehearsal.
And what if I flopped?
Then we would have ordered a sumptuous meal, charged it to room service, and drunk all the champagne compliments of the man.
And jumped out the window.
And this is why I want a 3-star hotel with accommodations above the 3rd floor.
Geneva, it's hardly jungle fever. They top Brussels,
King Marshawn?
No. Other than how attractive he is, how beautiful and intense his eyes are, what it would feel like to spend a week with him on a desert island. No, he's hardly entered my mind.
What about you?
Pretty much the same, except I imagine 3 weeks on a desert island.
Pretending to be a man has its disadvantages.
It does, especially when you're a man.
You drive me wild, and then you win my heart with your wicked eyes.
bless Mother, Grandmother Todd, Victoria, Victor, and Mr. Bernstein. Ah, men.
Get her. So when I met her, Dinner with her, with him, tonight.
So what's the big deal?
Not a big deal.
All right.
All right. So why am I as shy as a smarty-faced kid at a high school prom?
Why?
I'll tell you why. It's because I don't know where this crazy dame, this Victor guy, whoever he is coming from. That's why. I'm a guy who knows himself, so I really don't give a damn. I never could be in love with a man. But what if I am? I mean, me! Ha! Gay! Ha! If I know that I'm not, what's the problem I've got? And why do I feel this way? The only logical answer is, he's a dame. I know that I'm right. I can tell from the way that I feel. Yeah! So maybe the way to play is to go along with the game. If for some dumb reason I'm wrong, it's such a big deal. Yeah. I've never been wrong about dames, not once in my life. If I had been, you'd think that I'd be stuck with a wife. But not me, not king. My life has been one sweet perpetual fling. Things that I've landed the flame from each day of play that tricked her. But now, alas, I'm in love with Victor. Maybe I should see a doctor. Or concoct some cockamamie tale to get me out of town. Maybe take a long vacation with some appetizing chick to lift me up when I'm down. Or maybe I should face the music. Give up dames like Fame and Margot. Take aboard this strange new cargo. Did a fellow fancy Iago. I'll take Victor to Chicago and see what happens then when I'm out with him in 8 or 10 of the world's no question most obnoxious men. I'd like you to meet my beautiful boyfriend, Victor. How would it sound down at the stadium? How would it look out of the racetrack? Did you see how that at the ballpark would be Palermo? Give me the eye when I walk in with a guy. Of all God's gorgeous creatures who play tag with my libido, I have to pick the queen of drag who dresses tuxedo. I'd like you to meet my lover, not normal, Victor. What would they think down at the golf club? What would they say down at the nightclub? What would they say in Wheel Steakhouse the moment we were seen? Hey, did you guys know that a king marchand is a queen? It's a trick and a trap, but I'm not taking the rap for a crime I didn't do. I gotta make certain that he is a she. If I don't, all my nightmares could end up true. There's only one way to find out for sure. But I haven't got the guts to try. Or have I? If I'm right, I'll throw a party tonight. If I'm wrong, I think I'll die. Yes, I guess I gotta do it. Hell, there isn't that much to it. I can sit here 1 more minute, letting time go by. I need to put an end to all this how and why. I need to know, like most guys need an alibi. I'll go myself. I just can't ask a private eye. It's the girl I'm in love with. A girl.
Thank you.
later, Betty. Bye-bye.
Is Mr. Todd any messages? Thank you. Please put me through to Miss Marshall Street. Marchand Suite, please. Get that. Hello? We'll meet you in the lobby in 2 minutes.
Okay. 2 minutes.
Good.
need good help.
That's not a question.
Why is he all the way over there?
Strategic.
A broader field of vision for a clearer field of fire?
You must have been in the army.
I prefer the Navy myself. Do you mind if I go over there? He seems a bit lonely.
No, I don't mind.
I promise not to inhibit his field of fire.
Incorrigible.
Mr. Bernstein, may I buy you a drink?
Coffee.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight I am especially honored and happy that we have with us one of the great entertainers of our time, the toast of Paris, Victor. Perhaps, if we are lucky, she, he, will sing us a song. Maybe an old English tune, eh?
Yes, yes, I do.
Get up there and act like a man.
Trust me.
Why not? very happy again.
What's wrong?
Nothing. I'm just finding this trip to Paris a little bit more bizarre than usual.
Thanks a lot.
No, not you.
Why not me? A woman pretending to be a man, pretending to
be... Well, now you can stop pretending.
But what if I don't want to stop? I'm a big star.
Oh, that.
And something much more. For the first time in my life, I feel emancipated.
Emancipated?
Yes! I'm my own man, so to speak. You should be able to relate to that.
I have to be honest with you. Right now, I'm having a tough time relating to anything.
You think it would be fair for me to ask you to give up your job?
That would be ridiculous.
But you expect me to give up mine!
I'm not pretending to be somebody else. Look, what if the shoe was on the other foot, okay? What if you were the man and I was a woman pretending to be a man? Love is a two-way street. I can't believe I said that.
Do
you want me to be honest?
Always.
I can never live like that.
Because you're afraid that people would think you were in love with a man.
Right.
So, we've got a problem.
Yes, we have.
Are we almost a love song?
Are we a love song?
Not the one I feel the moment go by.
what do I owe the pleasure of your company?
I have something to tell you.
I'm all ears.
I'm gay.
He stole my heart. Does your boss know?
I just told him.
And how do you feel now that you've hoisted your true colors?
Scared, I guess.
Naturally.
And kind of like it's my birthday.
Because, in a way, it is. Speak of the devil.
Where is she?
She? It's a long, complicated story, isn't it?
How long have you been, you know?
Can't remember when I wasn't, you know?
Right. I know you 15 years. You were an All-American center for Notre Dame.
A center? Happy birthday, Mr. Bernstein.
Call me Squash.
Must
I? I think we should try living together.
Your place or mine?
What?
Thank you.
A toast to the new lovers. Knowing the boss, it's not going to be easy.
Knowing Victoria, I'm inclined to agree.
Harmony, for aught that I could ever read, could ever hear by tale or history.
Course of true love never did run smooth.
Mr. Bernstein, you surprise me.
We did Midsummer Night's Dream my junior year at college.
We did Hamlet.
I'll bet you were a romantic Hamlet.
No, I was a clumsy Ophelia. Your move.
Penny?
We've had dinner every night in the hotel for 2 weeks now. You know what I'd really love to do? Have a candlelit dinner at some romantic bistro and then go dancing?
Dancing?
Yeah.
Where?
Where people usually go to dance.
Where two men usually go to dance.
Oh.
Yeah, like maybe the Ritz.
Well, I'm getting a few more.
Don't you think I'd love to take you dancing? Have you all my arm in a gorgeous gown, strolling up the Champs-Élysées? You know how proud that would make me? I'm going out.
Out?
Yeah. A little exercise, some fresh air.
Worried about the boss.
Yes, your boss is not a happy man in love.
Is there a solution? Well, either Victor can announce to the world that he is a woman, or King can find some way of being joyful living with a man.
Darling!
Quote Shakespeare and plays chess like a Russian master. I'm afraid to ask. Do you cook?
I'm a great cook.
Here I was about to repudiate the good fairy. She must have given herself a hernia making you come true. Hello?
It's me. Can I come over?
Of course. Victoria, she sounds miserable.
I better check on the boss.
Drink?
No, thanks.
You look like you could use one. Would you like me to ask again?
It's not working out!
And you thought it would?
Yes! Well, I hoped it would.
In my experience, when it comes to matters of the heart, hope is never enough.
I only wanted to go dancing!
Where? At the Ritz?
I know, two men dancing at the Ritz would be orthodox.
True, but two men dancing at the Ritz is not your problem.
It's not?
No. Your problem is that you're not two men.
I don't want to be a man anymore.
I know. Neither do I.
here, Sal.
Oh, yeah? Where is he? Shacked up with a count?
He said something about the Arctic Circle.
Sure. And I'm bemoaningly soft.
Please tell me where your boss is, otherwise I'll juke your shoe.
Excuse me, boss. Remember, it's my turn?
Oh, yeah. We've been so busy, I forget who's supposed to shoot whom.
Home.
What?
You can't say whom, because there ain't no proposition in front of it. Isn't
any.
What?
Isn't any.
Preposition?
Shut up! Now, for the last time, Squash, where's your boss?
Mr. Marshall, suite, please.
Sal, I swear on my mother's grave.
Your mother's still alive.
You kid.
Shoot him.
Hold it!
My mother was a nun.
Give me Mr. Todd. Be in my room if you need me.
Thanks, Squash.
Anytime, Victoria.
Thank you.
accusations of a cruel host. This woman is no man.